I've decided to do a series of tutorials, some very basic stuff for filmmakers, showing them how to do just little things to improve things like their credits and effects and things like that. This first tutorial is for scrolling credits, credits that start at the bottom and go upwards. A lot of times when you create them, they're jittery, and so I've found a way to create credits that are nice and smooth and not jittery, and it involves first using Photoshop to create a JPEG of your credits. So here I have a new Photoshop file that I'm creating. You want it to be the same dimensions as your film, so you want it to create something custom. Let's say we're doing a 1080p, which would be actually 1920 by 1080. So here you have a new JPEG. You minimize it so you can see the whole thing. Okay, now you want a black background to begin with. So there we go. So this is the size and shape of the 1080p film frame. Now obviously you're going to want the credits to start and go up. So you're going to need for it to actually be a lot longer than 1080p, so that it can move up and down. So we're going to change the image size, actually. Change it to pixels. So we want the height to be probably 4 or 5 times that. So we're just going to go like really big at 6,000. Whoops. You have to unlock that first. And make it bigger, 6,000. So now it's 1920 by 6,000, so it's going to be really tall. Because you need it to move up and down. Let's see how big it's going to be. This is my film. And the reason you're creating a JPEG is because you want to reduce jittery text, and if it's just text on its own moving up, it's going to be jittery. There's no way around it. But if it's a JPEG moving up, it will not be jittery. It'll be nice and smooth. Get it of it. In the same spot, again, you want to put this in a folder that's going to be your project folder. Put it with your artwork group. Okay, then a new composition, which is going to, again, be 1920 by 1080. But that's the size that you're working with. Scrolling credits. And as far as the time, we'll just say 20 seconds for now. You can always change that and make it longer. Okay, background is black. The width will match, because we made 1920. The height will not match, which we don't want it to match. Now, we need to find the top of it, so what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and open that up, transform it, and we want to find the position, and move it down. Just grab it and move it down by hand. Okay, so that's the top. So you want it to eventually move up, so you're just going to drag it off the screen. Make sure it matches up on the sides here and here. Okay, so now it's off screen, and now you're going to go forward on your timeline to where you want it to end. So 20 seconds to the end. Now we're going to move it back up. Just use the arrow this time until it appears. Okay, there it is. I'm just going to grab it and pull it up to the top. All the way up. Make sure again that the sides here are matching up, otherwise it will wobble back and forth. Okay, so there you go, it's all hidden, it's gone. So what you did was you just started it at the bottom and you pulled it all the way up to the top. So when it moves on your timeline, the beginning of the timeline, you have a position marker here. It moves along and it ends basically. Okay, so let's go ahead and export this baby. Go to your composition, add to render queue, scroll in credits, that's what we're going to call it, final version, save it again in your project folder, go to your lossless here, this is lossless, and click resize so it will match your exporting at the same size as your frame here, which is 1920 by 1080. Double check that. Hit OK. Go ahead and render it, and it's going to save it on your desktop or your project folder. Okay, so let's save. Go ahead and save this. Save it. New project. Credits, scrolling, credits, again, you want to save it in your project folder, wherever that is. It's right here, movie, that's what we just created in After Effects. Okay. Now we're going to drag it into our timeline. Okay. There it is, it needs rendered. So go to your sequence, render in and out, this is yellow. You go nice, smooth credits, no jittery for lettering. It's clean, smooth. Nice credits, nice and big and bold.